of yours, it's I, James Comer, half-assed reporter, the guy on the bike. And we are back in Chelsea. We came in last week and saw Julian Schnabel's show here at Pace. And this week we're going to pop upstairs and catch a show by Jules de Balincourt titled Midnight Movers. Enjoy. Start here. Voices and Vessels 2023 Oil and Oil Stick on Panel. Jules is one of the people that was involved with the Bushwick art scene when it first took off. He bought himself a nice little building out there and put on some nice exhibitions there. Has a beautiful studio. And I've been popping in and seeing his shows for, gosh, at least 20 years, something like that. I think he was initially showing at a gallery, was it LFL Gallery, something like that? Nick Lawrence was one of the proprietors.
Do we have another location on the block?
Okay, one of the things you might want to note is that these are all on wood panels. And I always asked Jules, I said, doesn't that limit your size? And I mean, doesn't it get a little heavy and all that stuff? And he just said that he needed the hard surface and that he would figure out how to solve all the other problems when they came up. This is titled Three Harbors 2023 Oil and Oil Stick on Panel. I think there's also something about kind of finish you get if you're sanding through your paint on wood that's different than you would have if you were doing this on canvas. Okay, this is 34 by 30. Untitled. 44 by 48. And I believe that Jules was one of the people who was picked out for one of the Greater New York shows about 23 or 4 years ago that kind of kicked off his career. I used to have a little bit of interaction with him occasionally, but since I've been bumped off of Facebook and Instagram, I haven't heard much from him. Fires on the Mountain, 2023. This is 70 by 80. Perhaps one of the subject matters that Jules deals with that is becoming more pronounced is his ideas about climate change and it's kind of a dystopian future. I know that maybe even the first show that I saw of his work, he built a sculpture in the front room, and I believe it was kind of like a little town, and you could sort of watch it as the water would fill up and kind of inundate the town. I guess it was a statement about climate change and the melting polar caps. Divided camps. 70 by 80. Well, I would also say that there's a certain kind of a naive quality about some of these works that makes me think of Matthew Wong a little bit. I'm also looking at this and thinking that gosh, it almost looks like he's got some kind of fabric that he's glued onto his panel. Gosh, there's Marilyn Minter. This is punchy. The center does not hold. Isn't that a reference to a poem by Auden or some British poet? This is 82 by 94. Oil and oil stick. Okay, I like the kind of the juicy colors on here. I wonder if he's splashing a little bit or brushing a little bit of the paint medium on his oil stick. Meeting of the masses. /44. I actually like some of his more abstract pieces that are just dealing with the forms and the color more than some of his more narrative pieces. I think he's also good on a lot of various scales. Some people, like Julian Schnabel, it's like, if it's not 10 by 15 feet, it doesn't seem to work. Julian does a lot of stuff on various scales. He can do large or small. This is titled Fight or Flight. Okay, we've got a lot of various gradations in the green, which is great. Yeah, so we've also got a matte versus shining green. We've got a kind of a chunky impasto dream versus a very flat, thin green.
Yes.
Chalia 2022 34 by 30. I think the last time I talked to Jules, he was saying that he was spending a lot of time in a little island off the east coast of Costa Rica near Punta Arenas. He joked when I talked about Punta Arenas when I was a kid, I hitchhiked to Mexico City and then flew down to San Jose, the capital of Costa Rica, and hung out on Punta Arenas beach for about a week and a half. That's where a lot of American surfers were at. Had a lot of fun. Okay, here's an example of some of the smaller paintings I was talking about. This is very nice. The Archivist. And it kind of makes me think of some of Paul Klee's Tunisian watercolors. Small Castle 2023, this is 12 by 10 inches. Pink Horse. So it does look like he's doing some sanding on the grounds. Windswept. Medium TBC. So that must be some kind of panel that he's working on, maybe, I don't know. Well, if you're interested, you can go back in the files and check on a show that Jules had at, I believe it was Salon 91. I think I was able to snag him and get him to talk a little bit, briefly. This one too. Between Heaven and Earth 2023 is 70 by 80. It's very abstract. Yeah, I like the urgency, the spontaneousness of the oil stick. And those big kind of flowing forms. Okay, we're not going to be able to get a very good close-up of this one. Appropriately titled The Observer. Union Reunion, 70 by 80 inches. Well, I think that Jules was actually part of the mission school. Beautiful Losers group in North Beach in San Francisco for a while. Then he came to New York. I was also thinking that somehow I'm getting a little echo of a Enzio Cucchi painting. Because a lot of people don't remember him, but he was one of the three C's. Cucchi, Chia, and Clementi. I think Chia and Clementi came and started living in New York. I don't think he ever did, so they kind of wrote him off. The Escape is 2023. 34 by 30. Rainbow. Laser-avists, oil on panel, 34 by 30. Okay, so this is rather confounding. Are these people around a party boat? Or are they immigrants coming up on shore somewhere? I guess you could be both. Moon Shadows, 30 by 34. Okay, we're gonna wrap up soon. The people that paid and played. Okay, so this is interesting. Jules is kind of painting with the kind of the daubing pointillism of the nabbies. And the pastel colors. But it's another kind of dystopic landscape. Maybe it's after a storm. Or was it the Californado thing that happened on Cali a couple of weeks ago? Ended up with all the the debris in the swimming pool, but they've drained the swimming pool. Okay, here's our last one. Night portals. 2023. 44 by 48. Okay, so if you're just casually looking at this, you'd think it's just a evening landscape. And then as you start to delve into this a little closer, you start to see some disquieting details. So we've got a bunch of people maybe standing around a campfire. I wonder what this thing is. Some kind of a proscenium arch, or is that the gravestone? A nice slashing black line across the middle. Again, very interesting color things. Various shades of oranges, hot reds, maroons, wine color, and then with the purple and magenta background. So this has been James Kalm reporting on Jules de Balincourt. Midnight movers. He would pace. You can like this, share, link it up to all your social media sites, and you can subscribe. Leave your thoughts, ideas, comments, criticisms, suggestions, and reviews below. Just say thank you, Kate.
My name is Syd Hudson. I am a 15-year-old singer-songwriter.
Sue Hudson.
And I've been busking in the streets for a little bit over a year. And, you know, I'm just trying to get my songs out here.